out of Selma, the 600 peaceful protesters were met by hundreds of Alabama state police and local police. The policemen attacked the protesters. They used tear gas on them. They beat them with billy clubs. The protesters were whipped and stomped on by police horses. The leader of the march, John Lewis, took a billy club to the head. He very easily could have died on that bridge that day. 17 of the marchers were sent to the hospital. That happened on Sunday, Bloody Sunday, March 7th. Now, I said that they did not get out of Selma that day when they were beaten on that bridge. But the nation was horrified, and the movement was galvanized. And 2 days after Bloody Sunday, 2 days later, on Tuesday, March 9th, they went back. Only this time it was not 600 people marching that route nonviolently. This time it was not 600, it was 2,500 people marching that same route, and they marched to that bridge again. And then a week later, they took on that march again. Only this time they were protected by thousands of U.S. Army soldiers and National Guardsmen acting under federal command. And by the time that speech, that march, ended up at the Montgomery State Capitol, it was not 600 people. It was not 2,500 people. It was 25,000 people. And that was when Martin Luther King Jr. gave his How Long, Not Long speech at the State Capitol.
You don't want to say forget you.
The night before that last march started, the President of the United States convened a joint session of Congress to address
George
and to demand a very specific response. This is the night, of course, when President Lyndon Davis Johnson, Texas Raw, said live on national TV,
it's not more fun.
We shall.
It is a video, it's going to take a while.
Mr. Speaker, Mr. President, members of Congress. I speak tonight for the dignity of man and the destiny of democracy. At times, history and fate meet at a single time, in a single place, to shape a turning point in man's unending search for freedom. So it was at Lexington and Concord. So it was a century ago at Appomattox. So it was last week in Selma, Alabama. What happened in Selma is part of a far larger movement that reaches into every section and state of America. It is the effort of the liberals.